Ask a question about garden grubbing. I wonder, first of all, what your policy is on garden grubbing, because listening to you tonight, you've obviously put a lot of effort into identifying houses in need, therefore it must be down to greed. And you have allowed a few buildings recently around our area, which can be classed as grabbing land. The only people that really benefit are the owners of that particular land. And little scant regard appears to be paid to the neighbours who clearly object. If I could just follow that up with another point, there's another tendency where people will apply to build, say, a double garage or a garden room, then morphs into an annex for our lad, and the next thing you know, we've got a permanent dwelling, and the owner of that land now makes an awful lot of money. If you've identified all this land, why are you allowed to sort?
So there are two elements, I mean, the general sort of garden grabbing, as you describe it, and then people building on bits to their houses and then creating extra dwellings out of them. In terms of people knocking down houses, you know, if you've got a house and a lot of land, if that land is all in the urban area, then that's perfectly acceptable to knock one down and build three or something like that. Yeah, that's okay. If the garden is all in the countryside, then it isn't and wouldn't generally be something that would get allowed by the planning committee. So it depends on, you know, every case is taken in its individual circumstances. Part of those 8,000 houses between now and 2036, as I said, were needed to be built. We've got an allocation in there of about 1,000, which we would call windfall sites. And those windfall, we've pushed that envelope really as much as we can to be able to minimise the need for greenfield land. And those, you know, knocking down a house and building three where it's in the urban area, that would be contributing to those windfall needs. And if we don't get them, then we'll turn around partway down the line and say, we're not getting our windfall sites, we need more greenfields. And we wouldn't want to do that either. In terms of people extending properties, they need planning for some, generally, to do that. And nobody can create a separate dwelling house without getting a specific planning consent to be able to do it. They can build these annexes and they'll be tied up within planning conditions and legal agreements that if Aunt Flo, where she was, becomes deceased, then it can't be sold off as a separate unit. But there's nothing to stop people applying to be able to do that. But I've seen the planning committee generally resist that sort of thing. So sometimes, yeah, for very specific reasons, it could well have got past the planning committee, but generally they don't allow new dwellings to be created unless, you know, it's absolutely up front. You know, that's an urban piece of land, put a new house put on it.
Could you not create a rule whereby, when they're given permission to say, build an annex, that it must be sold with the house?
Well, we do have a legal definition which says that that annex has to be associated with that house, that it can't be sold off as a separate unit. And if they wanted to be able to do that, they'd have to first get a planning consent to make that into a separate unit. And then, you know, as it got its own services, its own garden, its own driveway and everything else that's needed.
Thank you very much.